I have a question to ask you. What if Major League Baseball or football, just one of those sports, or basketball, was removed from our economy? How would it impact our economy? Just think of it. All of the finances, all of the jobs that's involved, the owner's salaries, the player's salaries, the money that the states get, that the organization gets, all the jobs from marketing, promotions, the manufacturing, all of that from professional, collegiate, grade school, recreation, all of that just disappears from the economy. It can be devastating. Now just think about this. What if a new sport came into the economy that had a larger participating market than any other sport because it's age, gender, and disability neutral? And not only that, it's therapeutic. So just think of the impact that it would, the positive impact that it would have on the U.S. economy. And not only the U.S. economy, the world economy. It would be new monies spent, not recreating the wheel. I shared with Mark that I had come up with a different concept of bullet ball and how we could get more people engaged in playing and make it more competitive. Creating a team sport instead of a one-on-one competition. And it forces and engages people to work and play together to have a better understanding of the game. And it's a great, great spectator sport. In order for you to really understand how to play bullet ball, you have to learn how to hit the ball and have control of your hits. And be able to control the speed and the accuracy and pinpoint shots and things of that nature, particularly when it's a new sport. We came up with the rules for AbilityBall that allows you to have 3 30-second volleys. And the goal is to get your highest score within the 3 30-second volleys. And it's calculated by the number of hits between you and your partner.
Stop.